one?
I have to tell you one other thing.
I'm gonna say.
No, you're not, hold on a minute. If somebody doesn't cry, I will think that this is a total failure. And if it's you, thank you.
This photo was one of the best childhood photos I ever had taken. Gee, I was cute. I had mountain thick hair. Some people see that photo now and think I was wearing a wig. My dad was an amateur photographer and did take some great photos. In this picture, I just remember, it was in the upstairs in our house, in the hall. It was a sunny day and there was a full mirror behind me. I had the brattiest, cutest, most devilish look on my face. I didn't know then at age 4 that everyone was not going to be my friend like then when I was at that age. That I was not going to feel protected as I did then. And I didn't know that people you loved are not going to love you back. Not then, not now, not ever. And you can then choose not to love them then, if you're able. Whatever happened to that little girl who loved everyone?
I feel like Jennifer Lopez. I just got the little tiggities.
Thank you very much, Justin.
You're welcome.
That's what I'm talking about. Not that everything else that I haven't loved that you've shared with me, but there's something about that. I could actually see that. I could see the hair, and I could see the full-length mirror behind you. I could see the innocence of that child. Not because you told me, but because you described it to me. It's that old show don't tell. And it's your turn. You guys at the end, you two ladies, have been whispering to each other.
Yeah,
man. Helping each other.
Come on up.
Amanda and Kat, let's see some action up here.
Action.
You can? No? Mustn't.
I just have to say that the ability of the people who read to write with such cohesion, and I didn't even release the exercise, and then, I mean, how did they know to wrap it up like that? So I know mine is really, but not to compare, but I just, I feel very... I try to wrap it up to the description, so I just wanted to get it. But now I'm wondering if I should read my tree one instead of the pictures.
Let's do the picture, the picture, the picture. Okay. Is that the way you were almost crying?
No, no, no. When I was reading my description at the little first
picture. Oh, yeah. Good. Good, I like that.
Name, tree, or picture?
Whichever one feels more dangerous.
Well, they all kind of, I mean, I feel like I was kind of being, you know, anyway. But it wasn't really story, it was more. I'll read the picture. In this one, I'm with my dad. We're sitting on the beach in the summer in front of a log in swimsuits. I'm probably about 2. I'm in front of him, completely enveloped in his arms. We are squinting at the camera, our faces similar in expression, both holding what appears to be the same thought. It's a picture that takes me back to a time where I must have been so safe and loved, the whole world before me. I often wonder what my dad was thinking, a young surgeon surrounded by his kids and wife, lovingly protecting his only girl. He looks like I'm a treasure. We're gonna cry. My mom was obviously on the other side of the camera. My brother's playing nearby. When I see this picture, I sometimes want to scream at them. It was perfect then. Life could have been different. It should have been different. But it wasn't. That moment in time was a blank. We looked happy and content. I didn't know then that less than 10 years later, my parents would divorce bitterly, and it would put my life on a whole other trajectory. I was a little girl. I was loved. In that picture, every possibility still lived. They should have remembered about the day they took that picture. Maybe things would have been different.
Can I just say something about Amanda there, her presentation? She wrote these 4 rules. And then she read a story that we all loved. What's that about? You break all of the rules, you know, you preamble all of this rubbish, and then you give us a heartfelt presentation. Don't do that. Just give us the presentation.